You are probably more familiar with scalars. Scalars and vectors are both physical and mathematical quantities. A scalar can be completely specified by its magnitude, in other words, how big it is. Common physical quantities that are scalars include length, mass, time, and derived quantities such as volume and energy. A vector, on the other hand, needs to be specified not only by its magnitude, but also by its direction. Common physical quantities that are vectors include force, velocity, acceleration, and moment. Note that in print, the vector is normally expressed by bold letters. But in handwritings, we normally write a vector with an arrow on top of the letter. Like other vectors, a force can be represented by an arrow. It can be fully characterized by its point of application, its sense of direction, and its magnitude. The direction of the force can be described by the angle made by its line of action and a reference line. Sometimes you might see negative angles. This is because by sign convention, positive angle represents counterclockwise rotation and negative angle represents clockwise rotation from the reference line. To perform vector addition, we need to follow the parallelogram law. Let's say we have two arbitrary vectors A and B, and we want to find the sum, in other words, the resultant vector R, which equals to A plus B. First step, we need to join the tails of the two vectors together so that they are concurrent. Then, we construct a parallelogram using A and B as the two sides. And then draw an arrow that starts from the tails of A and B and points to the other end. This arrow is the resultant vector R, representing both the magnitude and direction of R. As a simplification to the parallelogram law, we can use the triangle rule instead. Again, we start with the two vectors A and B, and we want to find their sum, R. Instead of joining the tails of the two vectors, we now join them in a head-to-tail fashion, as you can see. Now, the head of vector A is connected with the tail of vector B. Then, the resultant vector R can simply be represented by an arrow that starts from the tail of vector A to the head of vector B. What if we want to do vector subtraction? For example, what is R prime that equals to A minus B? Since we know subtraction can be considered as addition with a negative quantity, therefore we can first find the vector negative B, which has the same magnitude but opposite direction as a vector B. Then we can simply add vector A and vector negative B together using again either parallelogram law or triangle rule. Let's look at this example. For forces F1 and F2, their magnitudes and directions are both given, and we need to determine the magnitude and direction of the resultant force of these two. For this problem, we're going to apply the triangle rule. So we join the two forces in a head-to-tail fashion. So this vector is the resultant force vector FR, and now the three forces form a triangle, and based on the geometry given in the problem statement, we can calculate that this angle is 75 degrees. Now this problem becomes solving a triangle. As you recall from trigonometry, for a triangle with sides of lengths AB and C, and the corresponding angles capital AB and C, to determine the relation of these parameters, we have law of sines, as well as law of cosines. Based on the information we have, We know that A is 100, B is 60, and angle C is 75 degrees. We can start with this equation to calculate the side length C, and then use this equation to calculate angle B. And here are the results. And from here, we can also calculate this angle right here, theta equals to 45 degrees minus the angle B, 34.5 degrees, to be 10.5 degrees. So we not only have determined the magnitude of the resultant force to be 102 newton, but we also determined the angle made by the force with the horizontal line to be 10.5 degrees. And this answers the question. Let's look at another example. In this case, we are given the magnitude and the direction of the resultant force, and we are also given the directions of its two component forces, and we need to determine the magnitudes of the two component forces. For this problem, we are going to first apply the parallelogram law and make a parallelogram based on the information given. And now we can visualize the two component forces we need to solve for. Then let's make the triangle again, calculate the third angle, and then apply law of sines directly to calculate the magnitudes of these two forces.